Now let's continue the same discussion and we will see what is the process to install Maven in your Ubuntu box. Okay, it is very, very simple. Okay, now what you need to do is you have to make sure that you have internet access in your VMware, right? Otherwise it won't work. Now, the first thing first, remove any older version of Maven if you have. Okay, so most likely if you are, you know, if you have downloaded a recent version of Ubuntu, then most probably you will not have this Maven at any time. But in case somebody has already installed, then if you want to remove those older version, then you can do so by just saying sudo apt-get remove Maven 2. And we'll just say remove any old version of Maven, password is Hadoop. All right. So it's saying package Maven 2 is not installed, so not remove. That's okay. Control L. Update your software repositories to the recent version. Okay, Control L. All right, so our system is updated with recent version of the software list. And now there is a single command, sudo apt install Maven. Okay, press Y when asked for. If it is asking you something to press continue, then you can say yes. All right, okay. Now, once this is done, you can just say check your Maven version. Okay, so when you do that, if you see, it is saying Maven 3.6.3 is installed, right? Which means your Maven is installed successfully right now, okay? All right, so now you have installed Maven as well, which means you can do your, you know, you can write some Maven command from your terminal as well. Okay, so let's go back. Now, once we have installed Maven, it's very important for us to create the jar file. Once your Maven project is ready, let us create a jar file out of it. Okay, so you'll just have to click on your Maven project and just say run as Maven build. Okay, now let's go back here. Okay, we are in our Ubuntu. We are inside Eclipse and this is my Maven project word count, right? Now what I'll do is I want to create a jar file of it. Why do I need a jar file? Because as you know, in Hadoop, we can run our program in a distributed mode, right? In a real-time cluster using Hadoop jar command, right? That means we need a jar file now, right? So we will go back here and say run as Maven build, okay? Which one to choose? You can choose this one, Maven build dot dot dot, because this will open a window, okay? This will open a window. Now goals. So what goals should you pick, right? So you have done this Maven build dot dot dot. Okay, goal can be clean install or goal can be clean build. Okay, so I'll tell you the difference later, but let's say install and then say apply and say run. All right, so we did something and let me check if there are any errors. Yes, there is little compilation error, and the compilation error is it says source option file is no longer supported, use 7 or later. Okay, I'll tell you what is the problem here. So when I was trying to build a jar file using Maven, it is saying, hey, your project by default is using JDK 1.5, but we need at least 1.7. okay, now what I can do is let me, you know, go to the properties. Okay, and let me go to Java build path, and if you see, it is using 1.5, right? So let me try to change this out. I'll say I would go to 11, JDK 11, JRE, all right? And I'll say finished, and let me say apply and close, but let me try doing this again. Okay, so I'll say right click, run as Maven build. Right, so clean install, apply and say run. Okay, now I can see there is still a failure. Okay, now this failure is because whatever we have added here, so let's see what happened to that place. I've made those changes here, right, in our build path. Is there any other place where, see, apply, Is there any other place where I can do that? I don't think so. Okay, so which means we have added this, but it is really not recognizing, right? So what you need to do is you need to add little piece of code on your pom.xml. Okay, and what is that piece of code? That piece of code is this. That piece of code is this. Okay, and how will you get this piece of code? It's simple. We will have to learn how to Google effectively, right? So see, whenever I get a problem in my company when I'm working, and if I come across this problem, I can see, okay, compilation error. This is what it is giving me. So what you do is try to copy this whole line. Okay, try to copy this whole line. Okay, and then put it on your Google like this, right? Put it on your Google and you will get the recommendation from people. Right, and that's how we will basically search. How basically we will search. Now see, somebody might have given that information. So somebody saying maybe that may not be accepted solution. I don't know. Yeah, you can specify Maven source and target version by specifying this to your pom.xml. Maven compiler source, Maven compiler target, something like that. Right. So whenever you come across any problem, any new problem, I would say Google it, and then you'll get the solutions very easily. But one such solution is this, right? You have to add this configuration into your pom.xml directly under project. So please make sure that you are studying my material very, very clearly, because all the steps are written very clearly. Because where do I need to paste it? That is important, right? You cannot go and paste it in a wrong place and it will fail every time. Okay. So you have to paste directly under your project. So copy this, go to here, and this is your project. So you can paste directly under your project. Yes. Right. And then if you want, you can format it. But this is how it should be, right? And let me say run as Maven build. Okay. And then say, okay. Okay, so it is again doing some lot of stuff in the background, right? And it will create a jar file for you. You have to configure this, details so that you can successfully compile your program. So let me copy this and keep it here. So yeah, so that worked, right? So that's really great. Now what we'll do is, we'll just go back and see where exactly that jar file is created. It's not it. So because we wanted to create a jar file. So I'll go back to my word count. Pom.xml is still showing me some error, even though it was built. That's okay. You can just ignore if you are getting some error as such, right? Maybe you'll have to upgrade this to 5.0.0 to avoid that, but that's okay. As long as you are getting it successfully compiled, it's absolutely fine. So what it's saying is, okay, so when you get this kind of problems here, project configuration is not up to date, you know, sometimes you may get this kind of error. So there's also one way to resolve it. You can just say Maven, and here you can go and say update project. Okay, and just select this and, you know, choose force update of snapshot and release and say okay. Sometimes that also solves the problem, right? So this has solved the problem for us. All right. Okay, so finally your code is error free in any ways. But now what is important for us to understand is where exactly this jar file is right now. So let's go back to target. Okay, this is the target folder. Inside the target folder, you will get a lot of things, but what is important is you have word count maven 0.0.1 snapshot.jar, right? So this is what you got, a jar file. Okay, now whenever you're working on a real time project, right? Whether it is a Java based project or whether it is a big data based project. And if you happen to use Maven, then at the end of the day, this jar file is what you will need. This jar file is what you will require. Okay. This jar file can be used further. So whenever somebody says, hey, I want you to build the jar and give it to me, that means they are asking you to run that Maven command and give it to them. It's not it. Okay. So once you have this jar file, now see, the name of this jar file is, let me go to pom.xml again. Okay, see here. Group ID is in.olc. Okay, artifact ID is word count Maven. And because of this, you are getting word count Maven. Because of this, you're getting word count Maven. And because of this version, you're getting 0.0.1 snapshot.jar. Okay. And if you change it to 2, and if you say Maven 2, right? And if you again build the project, say run as Maven build and choose anything, clean install. Right, it is saying build is successful. And let me refresh this. I'll say refresh. Right, so you got Maven word count Maven 2 0.0.2 snapshot.jar. Right, so this is how you can basically control the name of your file, artifact ID, whatever you want to have. Okay, all right. Now, what we will do is we've understood how exactly you create this jar file, right? So now what we will do is let us try to do the same thing using our terminal. Okay, because sometimes you may have to do this operation from your terminal. You may not get this Eclipse for to right click. Okay, so we already have installed Maven, and that's the reason I installed Maven. Okay, so the only reason why I've taught you how to install Maven is because sometimes you have to do it in your terminal. Can you give me some example? In your real-time production server, you don't have Eclipse installed. There you cannot say, I will go to the Eclipse and then right click and say Maven, right? All you will be given is this screen, a black screen, right? And here you have to execute that command, right? So the first thing first, figure it out, where is your project deployed, right? So let's check the path. So I'll say right click and let me say copy. I'll just say properties and let me check my resources apply. Okay, so I can see this is the current location. This is the location of my Maven project. Okay, so I have copied this location and let me open it here. I'll say cd paste. Okay, so I am into the place where I have my Maven project. So let me say ls, it should show you pom.xml, right? So you'll have to go to that place where you have pom.xml. Now from here, what I can do is I can say Maven, okay, clean. Just a minute, what it is saying, illegal, okay. These are warnings. Warnings can be always ignored. So I said Maven clean, okay, and let's see what happened. I'll refresh this target, okay? So I'll say refresh, okay? And see, the target is gone, right? When you say Maven clean, then it clears the target, done. Now I can say Maven install. Okay, it says build is successful, refresh your target, refresh. Right, so it did all whatever we had done earlier. Again, let me say Maven clean install. Right, so it will do the same thing, it will clean. So when you say clean, that means delete the target directory, and when you say install, that means regenerate everything. Okay, let me go back to my Maven cd m2 folder. I'll say cd, I'm in my home, I'll say ls-la, I'll say cd.m2, ls, I'll go to repository, ls, I'll go to in, ls, I'll go to olc, lsc. Now what I was trying to show you here is, our libraries are also added here, in.olc, right? And then I'll say cd word count Maven ls 0.0.1 snapshot cd 0.0.1 snapshot ls, and we have our jar file over here. And this is what your install does. Okay, so when you say Maven clean install, it builds the jar file, of course, but it will also publish your jar file into your local repository inside your .m2 folder. Okay, this is what I wanted to highlight, right? So you have the jar file here as well. Okay, let's move on. Okay, so that's what we will be doing is and now going forward, all our project would be a Maven project. Okay, so we will see how to run this program as a jar in some other class. Not today, we will just keep it for a different class altogether. Questions before I move to the next topic.